Hello, and thank you for joining us for another edition of Rail Rangers on the Road. Every month, the Midwest Rail Rangers take you to an interesting and unique railroad destination across the Midwest, including places in Illinois, Indiana, Iowa, Michigan, Minnesota, Missouri, and Wisconsin. The Midwest Rail Rangers, a 501c3 nonprofit, was founded in 2015 to provide onboard educational programs across the Midwest. Perhaps you have caught us on select weekends on the South Shoreline between Chicago and South Bend, Indiana. On private rail excursions featuring dome cars and other heritage rail equipment. Amtrak charters and motor coach trips organized by the 20th Century Railroad Club of Chicago. Open house events at the Wisconsin Great Northern Railroad featuring the Sky Parlor car and the Mark Twain Zephyr. And at various outreach events, such as Train Fest in Milwaukee and Mad City Rail in Madison, Wisconsin. And now, mark your calendar for the first Sunday night of every month at 7 p.m. Central Time for Rail Rangers on the Road. Without further ado, here is this month's program. Well, hello everybody.
Hello.
Are you fixing your hat?
That's right.
You can't do that when we're here. Boy, I got my pineapple shirt on.
I got my In-N-Out Burger shirt on.
Oh, all right. So, welcome to another edition of Rail Rangers.
Don't do it.
On a boat.
On the ocean?
Yeah, we're here. September 3rd, 2023. And thanks for joining us for another one of our Sunday night programs. And, well, sometimes we do a lot of train-focused programs, and other times we do, we take you to adventures all over the country and sometimes all over the world here with the Rail Rangers. And on this beautiful Sunday, September evening, a little bit of fall in the air back home in our headquarters, but not here. Where are we? Florida?
No.
No? Tahiti? Oh, Guam?
No. That's the
all right, where are we?
We are in St. Thomas.
Where's that?
The U.S. Virgin Islands.
Oh, yes. So, yes, our Rail Rangers on the Road are taking you all the way to the Virgin Islands. We've been all over the world this year from, you know, Guam is almost 10,000 miles away where we were just a few months ago. So we're expanding our program all over the world. So, so on this Sunday night, we're going to take you to St. Thomas in the U.S. Virgin Islands. Then we're going to go to St. John, also in the U.S. Virgin Islands. And then we're going to take you to the Florida Keys. So, truly a tropical experience tonight.
Nice and warm.
Yeah, not a lot of train stuff, but once we get to Florida, which is the third part of the program, we're going to show you, I think it's still there, what remains of the Flagler, which was the train that ran from through the Florida Keys over to Key West. So, what are we going to see here on, we're going to do a couple stops here on St. Thomas.
So sure, so in just a little bit, we're going to be going into the Coral World Ocean Park.
Oh, is that where you get eaten by sharks and have an accident?
Maybe you'll get eaten by a shark.
Oh, and then she'll be, the shark will eat her, or the alligator will eat her, and then you'll just hear, I didn't mean to. I didn't mean to get eaten, it just happened.
Exactly. I didn't mean to push you into that alligator's mouth.
Hey, maybe, maybe you shouldn't do that on video.
Yeah.
There's too many witnesses, too many people watching.
Right.
All right. So why don't we, we're also going to snorkel. So you get to see me snorkel on video. But so there is train stuff. It's just coming later. But we thought we would take you to the Virgin Islands anyway on this trip and show you some of the cool stuff here and some of the marine life and some of the snorkeling and maybe you've never been here before. Maybe after this you'll want to plan a trip after seeing this Rail Rangers on the Road program to the Virgin Islands. So why don't we, you want to show them some of the how beautiful the water is here on this September night?
And show them the front view.
All right, flip. Flip.
Flip already. All right, so here's one of the beautiful views.
Wow, look at that. Wouldn't you want to be here? Look at that beautiful blue. blue water.
That's right, almost turquoise.
And you're going to take people to the overlook? You want to walk people down to the overlook? Okay.
Yeah.
Oh.
Peek through the trees here.
Oh, well, we could go down there. I think it's a little easier to see down there.
I know, but
why don't we take
them
down there?
It's fun to let them try to see.
Oh, yeah? Handrail? No? Oh, handrail. So we're here at the dive center. You can see the
Koki Dive Center.
The Koki Dive Center. And we're going to go, or I'm going to go at least. You're probably going to sit on the beach or the book.
Probably.
But I'm going to take up scuba diving, and we're going to try to go see the fish.
See through that little hole there.
Oh, so there's the coral where people, and that's where we're gonna go in just a little bit after we take you to the marine the world there.
Maybe if we walk this way a little bit, we can go along.
Oh, there's more. Oh, okay. And then we forgot to mention in St. John, we're gonna go to the Virgin Islands National Park because we like taking you to the national parks, right? Oh, I'm not sure where Candace is taking us.
Almost like a jungle.
Yes.
So if you look through the crack there, you can see people on the beach down there.
Oh, are we going to go down there? Oh. Nice. Very tropical. We can peek through here. Or maybe that other. Oh, there's a lizard. Wow.
You getting him?
Look how you time that.
Yeah, just right.
I'm not sure what kind of lizard that is, but there's a lizard. Oh, you scared him.
There's two of them right there.
Oh. Oh, boy. Oh. Huh?
There's a baby one right here.
Oh, okay.
Here's the baby one. Might pop up.
Mmm.
He's chasing you.
Yeah, let's go.
He likes you.
Let's go. Let's go back to the main overlook and show them that again. So we're going to head down there after the marine world and take them snorkeling?
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. Well, we'll see you in a little bit.
We're going to... So make sure we get them here. It's the Coral World Ocean Park.
That's right.
Let's go in.
Well, everyone, we're here at the Coral World Ocean Park, and we're inside the underwater observatory. So since we don't have the high-tech technology to take underwater with us...
Unless somebody wants to donate an underwater camera to the Rail Rangers.
That would be awesome.
Yeah.
So you're able to see the fish through the glass here.
Oh, which ones can you see?
I've seen a trumpet fish.
Trump fish.
Trumpet.
Trumpet fish. Like... Yo, okay. Ooh, ba-doop, ba-doop. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right.
And I've seen... Oh. Oh, there's some big ones right there.
Oh.
Let's see. That might be the queen trigger fish.
Yeah.
There's some pretty big guys too floating around in there.
Huh?
Some even have teeth.
No.
Teeth.
No, there's no. Him?
No, bigger.
Oh.
No, it's only on the other side.
There's a little guy right here. Oh, there's some big guys.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh, that one kind of has your expression. Look. Look at that grumpy. Grumpy.
The grumpy look.
All right, well, we're going to move on to the next
one. No, they want to see more fish.
They want to see more fish.
Yeah. That's the grumpy Candace fish right there.
No.
Yeah.
Let's see what else we can see.
Oh, there's some different.
Oh, this is the big ones right here. That's the guy with the teeth.
Which one?
The one closest to the pole over there.
Closest to the pole.
Yeah, closest to the pole.
Which one?
Huh? Closest to the pole.
Oh, the big guy.
Yeah, he has
teeth. He has teeth? No.
He has teeth.
Wow. Yeah, that's the one that looks like Candace right there.
Uh-huh.
Look.
You need to open their mouth so we can see if they have teeth.
I don't want to see if they have teeth. That kind of scares me, fish with teeth.
They're all huddled in this one little area.
The big ones are.
Mm-hmm. See, there's his teeth.
Where? Which one again?
Right there.
Oh, that. Oh. Wait, where is
he? Oh, he went that way. He's over there. Mm. There's a little guy hanging onto the bottom of him.
Mm. Is that what they are? Yeah. Oh, great. Not the car variety.
Well, it looks like the car that's on my car.
Does it?
Mm. There's the toothy guy right there.
Where?
Right there. Closest to the stand now.
Him?
No. Down.
Huh?
Right there.
Him?
Mm-hmm. He's got his mouth open.
Oh, uh-oh. Wow. So that's what it's like snorkeling.
Indeed, without taking the camera underwater.
Yes,
yeah, it was a good dive. Good idea for
us. Like this? All right, what's next?
Outside. All right, so we're at the sea turtle exhibit.
I don't see any turtles.
Right down here.
Oh.
One guy right here.
Oh.
And then there's one guy over there.
Why don't you tell us what fun facts you have for us about the sea turtle?
Green sea turtles are the largest of the hard-shelled sea turtles. They can be found throughout the tropical and subtropical Atlantic, Pacific, and Indian Ocean, and in the meridian Mediterranean Sea.
Oh.
And they don't have any teeth. They have a beak, like a bird.
Kind of like you, no teeth.
So, here's their anatomy.
Oh. That's what an eye looks like?
Yep.
Oh. There they are.
And what's left of the crab here?
Oh.
The birds have gotten to him.
Wow. That's why you're so crabby.
Yeah. there's an iguana underneath the bench there.
No, there's not.
There is. Take
no.
a peek.
No, there's no.
Take a peek.
No.
Take a peek.
No.
Yes, take a peek.
I don't see any.
Underneath the bench.
Oh, hello. Recording.
Oh. Hi everyone.
Hi.
So Robert's gonna go snorkeling out
what?
In the ocean.
I am?
So we can't take you with you.
Oh yeah, we can. Here, let's flip the camera. We're gonna flip the camera around and let me get snorkeled up to show
all
people.
Right. Sounds good. You're gonna get suited up to go snorkeling.
No. Why don't you go snorkeling?
I'm good. I'm gonna sit here and read my book.
That's not exciting.
The twain shall meet.
So we got
an aquila.
Why do I put all this on?
Over your head.
That?
Yep, that one goes down your back.
This one?
Yep. Goes down your back. Between your legs.
Oh. Are we allowed to show this?
Sure, why not? Now you clip it in front at the bottom. Oh, you gotta get the clip out from between your legs.
What?
The clip between your legs.
This one.
No. There's another one.
Oh.
I think you might have gotten mine, but that's all right.
All
right. Hello everyone.
Hello.
I'm coming from the back seat of the car. We're going to get on that big red barge behind us here.
Ah.
And we're going to head over to St. John.
And we're down on St. Thomas, now to St. John?
That is correct. So let him look at the boat, Robert.
Well, good morning, everybody. We are in Francis Bay, Virgin Islands National Park, and gotta be careful here. I'm doing my camera person to trip. So it not only preserves the beautiful heritage, like you see, the natural beauty, there's also human history, as you can see over here. The building you're looking at was the last sugar factory constructed on St. John. It was built by George Francis in 1874, and it may never have been used. He died the following year. George Francis was born enslaved among the Annenberg plantation here. He spent his youth and early adulthood working in the sugar fields. In 1848, slavery was abolished on St. John. He remained on the Annenberg plantation where he once was enslaved. In 1862, Francis became a landowner when he received the title on a two-acre parcel of land on Mary Point, granted to him by the will of Annenberg's owner. Soon after he purchased the remainder of the Mary Point property, including the site at auction, in 1871, when the new owner
of the plantations left town, he sold the titles to both properties. And you can see that here. So it's kind of cool here, Virgin Islands National Park, because there's both the natural and human history. But let's go for a bird walk.
Like me, and we're going to take you around the pond to look at birds. It's a nice walk. We'll probably walk for about 45 minutes. We're going to have the opportunity to look in the pond. We don't have any rivers, lakes, or streams. We have these seasonal salt ponds, and we have our native ducks. We have some shorebirds, and then, of course, we'll walk into the forest where we could look for the perching birds, and then we're going to look at the beach where we can look to see if we can find the seabirds, like the pelicans and the boobies and the frigates. So we do have a really big group. Hopefully, here goes a little sugar bird. Everybody's going to have to keep their eyes open because, you know, if we see a bird and I say, bird, by the time people in the back get to look at it, it might not still be there. But hopefully we're going to have a good walk.
Good morning.
This is the pearly-eyed thrasher. It's like a mockingbird. They're related to robins. It will eat like a potato chip out of your hand if you stand still long enough. A lot of people that live here don't like them because they're aggressive. But I tell you, after Hurricane Irma and Maria, it was like a bomb dropped on us. It was devastation, and that was the first bird I saw. So to me, the pearly-eyed thrasher is a survivor. So he's just hopping around up in here. These grass quits, they tend to be right in the path, and then they kind of fly up. For a lot of people that don't live here, it's a life bird because I don't think they're in North America, so people do enjoy seeing them. So just kind of look ahead at the path. Yeah, we have, oh, that's another little grass quit. Well, let me see. It's a little small seed-eating bird. It's got a cone-shaped bill. I think it's a female grass quit. The other bird it could be, but I think it's too small. Is a bullfinch. But it's right up there.
Did you say bullfinch or goldfinch?
No, bullfinch. We have these little, I think it's a grass, but it just flew.
And then up here.
Well, it came over here. Yeah, they're little small seed-eating birds.
Ooh, oh, okay.
Yay! There's been a shortage of pelicans. We're not sure if it has anything to do with the storm, but people have been noticing that.
Is he still sitting there?
Mm-hmm.
Is it giving you pouty lips?
Mm-hmm.
Well, hello everyone. Welcome to the Virgin Islands National Park.
Well, we're here. Look how beautiful.
Located on St. John.
Yep.
So we grabbed our Junior Ranger book, of course.
Yes, and you could become a Junior Rail Ranger, too, by going to railrangers.org.
That's right. So.
But this is a Park Service.
This is the official Park Service one.
You're 43?
Yeah, 43. Wow. So I completed my book, so I got my stamps.
Well, let's focus on those. Oh, there we go. Oh, for Virgin Islands National Park and the Coral Reef.
Park, which you can snorkel around. It's pretty cool.
Yeah.
So if you're a junior senior ranger like us,
yeah,
you have to complete all the activities in the book, which are not difficult.
No, this one was pretty easy.
Most of the answers can be found in the visitor center here.
Yeah.
So you answer it. I think my favorite one was, they give you local recipes.
Oh. Johnny cakes.
Johnny
cakes.
So
we could try some of these when we get home.
Yeah, Johnny cakes is probably my favorite
one.
And
then you could fry some fish up for us.
Neither one of us eat fish.
Yeah, okay.
Anyway, and then at the bottom they tell you to come up with your own recipe.
Oh, all right.
I cheated and just picked Johnny cakes, and then you dip them in cinnamon and sugar at the end. So it's kind of like,
and then you earn, like we have a Junior Rail Rangers badge, you have the, let's show everybody there. Oh, look at that. All right.
Virgin Islands.
Yes.
And wear it on your vest or your hat that you might have.
Yeah. You want to take people in the visitor center real quick, show them some of the exhibits, and maybe get your, there's the park sign. All right.
List of the daily use fees.
Yeah. And we're going to take you to some of the, we're taking you some of the beaches a little later.
That's right.
Trunk Bay, I think we're going to go to, so.
So it's named, the Virgin Islands makes us think of a place untouched by time.
Oh.
So.
And you can see some of the mangroves there. And we'll see some of those in the Everglades, which we're going to take people to next.
So this talks about all the coral reefs.
Oh.
The different types of coral. This is brain coral for the design. It much looks like a brain.
Oh.
Staghorn coral. And then an elkhorn coral.
Oh, that's pretty.
So they talk about the different types of underwater communities. The shoreline.
Mm.
Again, the mangrove plays an essential role in tropical and coastal ecosystems.
Yeah.
Oh, look at this little guy.
Oh, he's so cute.
He's called a ghost crab.
Oh.
And he scavenges the beach for food and keeps the sand clean.
Oh, okay.
So here's some artifacts that they've found over the years.
Because Columbus actually landed here in the West Indies, not in America proper.
Yeah, so Columbus's arrival from Spain in 1492 led to the death of... Ooh, sorry, bad.
Yep, thousands of natives who've lived here. And you kind of see out here, there's the ranger boat. And tonight we're going to go on a boat a little later tonight.
We'll take you on a sunset cruise.
We'll take you on a sunset cruise. It's supposed to pull up here in a little bit. So here's so very mountainous, which I don't know if a lot of people realize, but it's pretty. So where are we? We're right here in Cruz Bay.
Right here.
That's how mountainous. That's the island of St. John. It shows you how mountainous it's pretty mountainous. We've done the drive. And
so here's the underwater trail or the reef.
We're going to show you that too tomorrow, later. Well, tomorrow.
Later.
Later. Yeah.
And then it talks about some of the times and changes over the years.
Mm-hmm.
Since the plantation era, this island was mainly sugar plantations.
Yes. Yeah. And of course, lots of slaves were brought here.
So then they talk about how they freed them and they ended up owning the land and ended up working the land for themselves. Some baskets. This is a fish trap.
Oh. I'm going to take them out and show them the dock. There's the information counter and the gift shop.
Got seagrass beds, which we can kind of show you in the little marina area here. There's lots of seagrass in there.
Yeah.
So this is a really great park to come to, especially if you feel like a warm weather destination, and it's great to see our national parks in other parts of the world.
Well, where are we? We are headed out to Virgin Island Coral Reef National Monument.
That's right. So we're on that sunset cruise that we talked about earlier.
That's what do you have in there?
Punch.
Rum punch?
Yes, rum punch.
You're drinking on the job for the Rail Rangers? So we're headed out to the Coral Reef National Monument.
That's,
so tell us all about the history of the coral reef.
I told you about the different types of coral when we were in the visitor center.
Oh, okay.
All right. See you the next segment.
Well, should I show them the coral reef?
You can walk them through.
I don't think I can. No, don't take my drink. Wow.
Everyone, we're here at one of the top 10 world's beautiful beaches, and that's Truk Bay on St. John in the National Park. My head's
there you
going
go.
A little floppy because it's windy.
Yeah, it's beautiful. Look at that.
Beautiful turquoise water.
This is a real hard assignment for you with the Rail Rangers to have
yeah,
to come
I know.
Here.
It's horrible.
It beats the Fenland Elevator in Dubuque and some of the other places we've been, that's
yeah,
for sure.
Yeah, so if you get a chance, come down to St. John, U.S. Virgin Islands, come to Truk Bay Beach.
You can
make
see
sure you get here early so you can find a parking spot, though.
Yeah, because we got here, what, 9 o'clock, and it was still
yeah, it was pretty cool.
Crowded, but you can see the overlook.
There's an overlook up there, so you can stop and look down onto the beach. Ruins of an old sugar plantation up on the hill.
I'll see if I can zoom into it. Right in the center there. Yeah, kind of see the tower sticking out.
Yep. And then Robert's going to take you down the beach and show you where the markers are for the underwater coral trail.
So why don't you tell people what that is?
Really? So, here's a question for you guys.
Oh.
Is coral a plant or animal?
I think it's a plant, right? Because it's on the it's got leaves on the bottom of the.
No, coral doesn't have leaves.
No.
No.
It's an animal.
It is an animal because it is a living thing and it eats the microorganisms in the ocean.
Oh. Okay.
So Robert will take you on a walk down there, and hopefully we'll see you at our next stop, Maho Bay.
And that's where the sea turtles are.
That's right.
But we'll take them down, and you'll be able to see three boys, red, white, and blue. And they have markers there, historic markers out there. So we'll get a little bit of closer, and there's people, a lot of people snorkeling out there. So we'll walk the beach and show them that, huh?
Yes, we will.
All right. Where are you going?
Back to cover up my legs so my pasty white self doesn't get burnt.
Oh, okay. All right. All right. So yeah, I guess she's gonna go back. And they actually, like I said, they have underwater markers, so you have to have snorkel goggles on, but you follow where the three boys are out there, and they have historic markers, just like they would like a roadside historical marker, except they're, I don't know, 10, 15 feet underwater or whatnot, so. But you can see all the people snorkeling. I'll take you out a little bit.
One last stop on the beach here in the Virgin Islands.
And where are we going?
We're headed to Florida.
I want to stay here.
This is Cokie Beach, by the way. Make sure you come check it out. The lower bar is the best one.
You can smell the weed, yeah.
So we're going to take you to the Everglades and Key West. We'll see you there.
I want to stay here.
We'll see you there. All right, everyone. So
we're heading to Key West.
That's right. We're heading to Key West, and here we have the old bridge from the Flagler Railroad.
So we have to include some railroad in just about every story here.
Yes, so that railroad there once ran from Miami all the way to Key West.
Where we're going in just a little bit.
That's right. So Robert's going to get you some more information about the Flagler Railroad and maybe some pictures.
The Florida Keys would not be the vacation destination they are today if it wasn't for the vision of Henry Flagler. Henry Flagler saw the benefit of connecting Key West with the rest of the country after construction of the Panama Canal began. It was then that he decided to expand his railroad from Miami through the Florida Keys. He knew this would not be an easy feat and was told by many engineers that it could not be done. Not easily deterred, Henry Flagler finally found someone who also believed in his vision, project engineer James Meredith. It would take 7 years, over $50 million, and 17 million cubic yards of material placed on the right-of-way to see his vision become a reality. At any given time, there were more than 4,000 men working to build the railroad. During construction, three hurricanes passed through the Keys. The railroad was finally complete in 1912 and was called the Eighth Wonder of the World. The railroad remained in operation until the Labor Day hurricane of 1935. The hurricane ripped through the Florida Keys with winds estimated at 200 miles per hour. It is considered the most intense hurricane to make landfall in the United States. After the hurricane, there was some damage, but the railroad remained mostly intact. Due to the high cost of building and maintaining the railroad, the company chose to sell the railroad to the state of Florida and Monroe County for $640,000. The process began to convert the railroad into the highway had already begun. In 1938, the overseas highway opened. As new bridges replaced the original railroad bridges, the historic bridges were unused. In 1979, the third longest historic railroad bridges were listed on the National Register of Historic Places. This included Long Channel Key, Knight's Key, and Bahia Honda Channel. In 1997, a task force was created to preserve the bridges and open them for pedestrian and recreational use. In August of 2004, the remaining 20 historic railroad bridges and the overseas highway were listed in the National Register of Historic Places. The Florida Keys Overseas Heritage Trail is now a multi-use trail with a rich history. When you visit, be sure to stop at the historic bridges that were instrumental in creating the Florida Keys you now enjoy.
Cool. All right, everyone. So we're finally made it to Key West, Florida.
Oh, is that where we are? Is that why you're so sunburned? Okay.
I'm not sunburned. Yeah. Just a little red.
All right.
So here we have Harry Truman's The Little White House.
Oh. So tell us a little what you learned. We just went on a tour. We couldn't film, but...
We did. So he came here 11 times during his presidency.
Oh.
Almost. And this is where he decided to come the very first time when he was suffering from a cold because it was warm and he was tired.
Oh.
And it was just a wonderful place, and it was actually a naval base, so it was secure for the president at the time.
Okay.
So one of the fun facts that I learned was that he was an avid poker player.
Oh.
He just liked to play for the camaraderie, not for betting.
Yeah.
But also he had some heart issues.
Oh.
So he would take a shot of bourbon in the morning and sip on a bourbon at night to help with his heart.
Oh. I have heart trouble too, yeah.
So we're gonna go look at his 1950 Lincoln Cosmopolitan limo.
Oh. And they have a copy of the paper that he held up on the train.
That's right.
We have to have we're the Rail Rangers on the road,
right.
So we have to have a connection. So tell us about that.
So he toured
defeats Truman?
Dewey didn't
defeat Truman, but the paper said Dewey defeat Truman because it was a misprint in the Chicago Tribune.
Correct. So he was on the back of the train in St. Louis, Missouri, held up the paper that says the buck stops here, and he used that from there on as his motto.
Or it said Dewey defeats Truman, one of the two.
Oh.
Yeah. Okay.
So the buck stops here was his ultimate slogan.
Yes.
And no one took responsibility except for him.
There's a picture of the llama.
So it's okay for fighting.
It's what?
I didn't say anything.
Yeah, you said it's... Yeah. Oh, well, tell people about it.
So it's a 1950 Lincoln Cosmopolitan stretch limo. It's one of the 9 limousines staged at various cities throughout the United States for use by the president at the time. Unlike today, where the president's motorcade is transported by air as needed, this vehicle was based and was reserved for the president's use whenever he was here.
Oh, okay. So, one of the things to check out in Key West?
I guess usually it's right here, but it's not here right now, currently.
Oh. One of our friends has followed us, the chickens.
The roosters.
So where are we going next?
I'm just going to walk around the property a little bit.
Woo-hoo! All aboard.
So here's a cool way to get around town.
It's a train?
The Conk Tour Train.
I didn't know they still had trains in Key West.
So.
Oh, look. Woo-hoo. Look at that.
So
what is it?
It's...
Does it have rail?
No, but it's still a train. It's fun. It's fun. Historic Tours of America.
Ah, but it's not running on...
Not on rails, on the street.
Oh.
So, but still a neat way to get around town.
And we're still in Key West.
We're still in Key West. All right, everyone. So we made it finally to the Everglades.
Oh, look. Look at you.
Everglades National Park.
Yes.
So we're going to go on a tour of the Nike missile base that's here.
Like the shoes? The
No.
See, I got Nikes on.
No.
Oh, okay.
And then tonight we're going to go on a ranger walk and talk around the boardwalk to see alligators at night.
So, that sounds... What?
Yes.
What? No. What? At night?
At night. So make sure you bring a flashlight if you decide to do that walk, because you'll need it.
All right. Then do we get to go home after we see the alligators at night?
Something like that, maybe. We'll be back home.
Soldiers here. The farthest you could have driven was probably to about right over here. You know, you had a security guard here that would access the entry or the departure of soldiers going in and out of the base. Now, this building here is this building right here, the pink building, the admin building, the administration building. And so in the administration building, all 130 soldiers had access to this barn. Okay, so in the year 1965, A Battery received the permit to construct the permanent missile base here. B Battery was stationed up in North Key Largo, okay? So this battery is A Battery. So we are here talking about the soldiers of A Battery, okay? So the 130 soldiers had access to this building. This building housed them. It fed them. You had the dining hall located also inside this admin building. The bigwigs had offices inside this admin building. Since this was a residential area, there needed to be recreational opportunities. There used to be a pool. It's long since evaporated. There used to be a basketball court. The basketball court is still here. You can see the basketball hoop next to the light post. Right by the gate. Right through there. So during that first, you know, in this first section, all 130 had access. Then it started to become a bit more exclusive. Behind the administration area, you had the IFC, the Integrated Fire Control. The IFC was the area that housed the big, tall radar tower. These radar towers would have been seen where the prairie meets the grass. And then past the prairie along the horizon, you guys see three barns? Well, those three barns were the barns that housed the missile, about 1 mile away from the IFC. Now, these radar towers were used for several things. One of them was to help determine the location of enemy aircraft. But it was also to help track and log the Nike Hercules missiles if the missiles were to have been fired from here. Now, the Nike crewman needed about 36 seconds to launch the first missile. Now, what is the missile that Ranger is talking about? Well, the missile that I'm talking about is the Nike missile, right over here. These are the Nike missiles. This is the Nike Hercules missile. Now, question for you guys. Why do you guys think the U.S. Army decided to name their series of missiles Nike? Why not Adidas or Reebok?
Victory.
You got it. Greek goddess of victory. Hence why the U.S. Army decided to name their series of missiles Nike. Now, there were three generations of that Nike missile. The first generation was the Nike Ajax. The one that we have in stock is the Nike Hercules missile. These were the ones that would have been located here back in the day. Now, the radars, the eyes of the base. And even fewer people, even fewer soldiers had access to the downrange where the missiles were maintained, assembled, managed, and fired. So, we've got three barns. Barn A, Barn B, and Barn C. We think each barn housed from 4 to 6 missiles. And from those 4 to 6, 1 in 4 were nuclear missiles. 6 soldiers stationed in each of the barns. 6, 12, 18, about 20 soldiers had access, exclusive access to this site. Now, if you were one of those soldiers, you would have been greeted here with a guard in a guard tower, and this guard would have greeted you with a big old grin from ear to ear and a 12-gauge shotgun and asked the reason why you needed to be present. This was a two-man rule. You couldn't come alone. You had to come with your partner. And so the guard would oftentimes ask your partner, your business, and vice versa to see if you really had access to this site. Now, alrighty. So for the people who haven't seen the Nike Hercules missile yet, this is how the Nike Hercules missile looks like. It was a heavy missile, but the soldiers did depend on the railing system to allow the soldiers to move the missile in and out of the barn without any issue. The railing system, you can see the remnants of the railing system down this driveway. And then you've got 3, 1, 2, 3. Those 3 cabinets were the launch pads. You know, and so if you heard that drill, you'd push the missile outside of the barn, down to the launch pad, and you let the launch pad do the rest. The launch pad had a complex hydraulic system that would then, you know, aim the missile accordingly. Now, when the missile was ready to get fired, you couldn't have a missile fired at a 90-degree angle because what comes up must come back down. Mm-hmm. It was about an 87-degree tilted angle. Mm-hmm. I'm going to open up the doors. We're going to have this great dramatic reveal. We'll be inside for about 10, 12, 15 minutes, and then I will try to rally us up to conclude. Does that sound like a plan to everybody?
Yes.
Can we make pictures in this?
Yeah, sure. Yep, we encourage that.
Is that Martin graffiti, or is that pictures from all over? This is Martin graffiti.
Oh boy.
It gets better. It gets better. It gets better.
Wow.
Ta-da! Pretty cool, huh? About 40 feet in length. From tip of the booster to nose tip. Maximum speed of 2,700 miles per hour. Maximum altitude of up to 100,000 feet. And the range was of up to 96 miles. So it wouldn't have reached Cuba. Cuba's 160 from here. Remember, these were defensive, not offensive. Please come inside, make yourselves at home.
All right, so we are in the Everglades walking on the trail here.
Oh, yeah.
Royal palms.
Royal palm.
And
we can't let you leave Florida without what? Seeing a...
an alligator.
There's not one there.
Look down there.
No, I don't want to. That's a shark.
It could be an alligator, too.
And there's not one down there. Oh. Oh. So I guess our mission is complete.
He's a baby. A little guy.
Wow.
All right. So there you go. Alligator sighting.
Wow, I guess all good things must come to an end, and so must come to an end this program.
That's right. So we hope you enjoyed our little trip to the Virgin Islands.
Yeah.
And Key West, Florida.
And the Everglades.
And the Everglades.
So hope you enjoyed this program, and we will see you back for another Real Rangers on the Road. Oh. Yes, every Sunday. Every first Sunday of every month. So that would be October 1st, 2023, 7 p.m. Central Time. Our next exciting virtual program coming up. And we'll see you then.
See you then.
I guess we have to head back north and be out in the cold.
No. Such the life.
Yeah. Bye, everybody.
On behalf of the Midwest Rail Rangers, thank you so much for joining us for this program. Here's a look at the next program. Make sure you mark your calendar for this, and we look forward to seeing you then. In the meanwhile, if you're planning an Amtrak trip, don't forget about one of our exciting and interesting rail route guides. For more information, go to www.railrangers.org. That's www.railrangers.org. And click on the Rail Rangers store. There are plenty of options for both local and long-distance rail route guides in traditional book format, PDF ebook, and even MP3 podcasts. Until we gather together next month, the first Sunday of every month, 7 p.m. Central Time, we hope you have a great week and a great month ahead, and come out and join us on one of our onboard educational programs. For a listing of our in-person programs, go to our website. Again, that's www.railrangers.org, and click on Upcoming Events. Until next month, we'll see you then.